So hello and welcome to another episode of The Way to Bee. I'm Frederick Dunn, and during the last weekend of October of 2024, I was invited to the Pennsylvania State Beekeepers Conference in State College, PA. I decided to interview two of the vendors that I've not interviewed in the past. The first is Hive IQ, and the second is the owner of the Hogg Halfcomb cassette system for making comb honey. He had something brand new there that I think you're going to find very interesting. Thanks for being here today.
All right, so Nate, here we are, Pennsylvania State Beekeepers Association, and you're representing Hive IQ. Now, this is new to me, so if you could just give us a quick rundown, the concept behind the hives and what some of their best features are.
Sure. So this is a expanded polystyrene hive. One of the primary features is that we have a heavy insulated system that has interlocking channels, so it seals up tight. The bees actually love a really sealed environment. We were just talking about that, so it's almost R10 lid, R7 sides, and essentially what that does is it draws out any moisture safely away from the colony. Because it's polystyrene, it's never going to absorb moisture, so it's not going to rot. The polystyrene is not UV stable, so you do need to paint it. But this EPS system, we expect to last 10 plus years. We know these products have been out on the market for a number of years, but we think we've assembled them in a way and added some features that are really going to take it into the next generation. Mm-hmm.
So now you're offering, these are 10 frame standard lines. These are 9.
But the profile, the size of the box is such that it's just a little bit... just a little bit more narrow than a regular 10-frame box, and just a little bit longer. But for all intents and purposes, it will—it's about the footprint of a 10-frame hive.
Okay, so 9 deep.
9 deep or medium.
Or medium. Okay, so if they buy a kit, you're talking about 2 deeps and then a medium and the bottom board.
Lid and base and a queen excluder.
And the queen excluder is metal. Okay. Do you have a bottom board that's by itself that we could take a look at?
Yeah. Bottom board has a number of features.
Okay.
I can bring this up for you. So let's start with a 3-stage entrance system, right? So you can pop this up one of 3 ways and lock it into place. We can do left, right, or center. The only thing I can't do is close it 2/3 of the way on the left or the right. It's either completely open there.
Okay.
Or we can do something like that. Lock it into place. Magnets help hold it along with these locking channels. This is just call this a blanking plate. What we have is a pollen collection system. Get into later, but this is where your pollen trap goes.
Okay.
Screened inner cover, or screened bottom board, excuse me. Varroa tracks. These hold a piece of corrugated plastic that insert for blocking wind drafts in the winter, or if you're still taking sticky board counts for doing that in the summer. Really, the only time you see bearding is when people leave the varroa board in. Other than that, the bees really don't beard up too much in summer.
Now this takes a core flute slide in, like
the,
those?
The kit will come with it, but yeah.
It'll come with it.
It'll come with it. So yeah, it's a piece of corrugated plastic, much like a political sign or something like
What's
that.
What's this little?
So that's where the pollen trap goes.
Oh, okay.
I don't know if it turns it into too long of a... So this is actually one of my favorite pieces of engineering. It's so simple. So this mechanism sits in here, and really, you can turn your pollen on and off for a day. So that'll pop in and just essentially raises and lowers it. So the bees don't have to learn a new way to come through. And
right.
They just make their way.
So this comes out.
That comes out.
That goes in, and then the bees come right through that opening, and they come up through.
Okay. And then we have a tray that you just put in with the varroa, where the varroa board would go, so that slides under there.
And that collects the pollen?
And that collects it.
Okay.
In the future, it'll actually work with this hive pallet system, so you can collect a lot more. We'll have a bigger tray. But, we're looking 10 years down the line, because we expect people to have this equipment a long time, and some of the designs, that go along with our hive stand and our hive pallets are with the intention to commercially make our sensors available for the system as a whole.
Okay. So right now, if people are shopping for these, mm-hmm. what's the name of the website? Just hiveiq.com. We already showed that. Okay. And this is, what are the options when they're looking for kits?
Right now we have a 3D kit and what we're calling a USA kit. The USA kit is two deeps and a medium. And the 3D kit is obviously three deeps. Two major things that I hear from people is that sometimes they want all mediums. And sometimes they want to just run the double deep setup. So I think in the future you're going to see multiple options for something like a build your own kit. Tell us what you want. And then if you're getting into a certain number of hives, let's say commercial or sideliner, and you want 200, we can do custom orders.
Okay. And the other thing is, we spoke earlier already about this, but your hive covers and the options for feeding your bees.
Right.
You've got something in the works. It's not yet released.
Right. So we have a hive top feeder in the works. It's more than in the works. It should be available here mid-January. And that's going to fit inside a medium here. It's going to sit right on the rabbit. And so it's a rapid feeder. It's not an edge feeder, so the bees have access to the syrup all at once. You can also use a cap and ladder. And then after that, we expect software and sensors. And then, everybody wants what they've had. We've had 150 years to get together for the Langstroth hive. And we're just trying to make sure everything that we bring to market is quality and it's going to last. So while we can't, do it all at once, we're trying to do things in a priority mm-hmm. list. But I expect a feeding shim and a treatment shim.
Okay. And I guess let's go over the features of the cover itself.
Yeah.
And let's talk about the R factor. That's interesting to people.
Yeah, so I can't recall what it is per inch, but we're almost to R10 with the strong back of the lid. So this will come unassembled, but this is a powder-coated metal that's glued on in the factory there. And you would essentially just paint the edges here and screw the profiles down. But it's high density, right? So anytime a bee, and this is why we bring up this picture of the tree cavity, anytime bees move into a bee tree, they're going to remove the soft wood first, and once they get to the hardwood, then they said, okay, we've reached the outer edges, and we're going to start to propolize. So that is what you see happen with this material as well. It would be understandable if you were to look at a polystyrene system and say, how is that mimicking a tree cavity? Well, it's completely inert. It's non-off gassing, and the bees recognize the density much like they would the tree cavity, and they start to propolize it. Other than that, it's got a good solid weight to it.
Yeah.
And one of the things that we also recommend with this system is locking it down into place. We were talking about CO2, and there's even some research being done into the positive pressure that is created in a completely sealed environment. So a brick works well, a cam lock or a hive lock system works better. Now everything's completely sealed, and it's just got a good pressure on it all the way around.
Okay.
I suppose the other thing, if we're talking features, is this little 45-degree chamfer here. So this was designed so the bees have somewhere to propolize and put the propolis that they collect. But what this allows is for a really clean sealing of the hive that's actually easier to prop open than some other systems. So we developed this hive tool where it's got this step here and this 90 on this end for your hand to push in. And so if I'm pushing down, it's easy to slide in here, run my hive tool along there and break that seal, and then I can just go up or down. So while this hive tool will work for any number of systems, we designed it with ours because you don't have the option to go straight into the corner. So we use the flat edge and crank it up, crank it down.
So just to be clear, it comes already yellow with these hardware surfaces, and people will be painting there.
Assembling and painting. So it is, you got to glue it, screw it, and paint it.
Now let's talk about those screws. What are they made out of?
I don't know.
Okay. Because sometimes the screws I've noticed with other polystyrene hives, or sometimes they're just a carbon steel, almost a sheetrock screw or a drywall screw, and they rust easy. And I notice that yours have, at least they're painted.
So you won't see. Any of these screws after they're assembled.
After assembled, okay.
So like our screws are right here, here. There's 8 screws per box.
Okay.
And they're underneath these profiles.
Oh, so they're not exposed to the weather anyway.
They're not exposed.
But we do
to the
see some screws on your bottom board.
You will see them on there.
So is this the same type of screws?
I think they're a little bit different. I know we've played around with coarser grain.
Okay.
And that's just
they
a good
seem
question.
Better to me. That's all, because they do have a finish.
Yeah.
So they might be powder coated or something. We don't know.
I don't know.
All right.
I need to learn that.
So price point, that's the number one thing people are going to want to know before they go to look at them. If you're buying the 2-deep, medium, full kit, what are we looking at?
$279.
And shipping within the United States?
We do our best. We actually were just able to negotiate and get some lower prices on shipping. We pass that along to all our customers. We also encourage you to go check out our dealers.
Okay.
Dealers are going to be able to answer your questions and speak from experience. And we wouldn't have half the exposure we have now if it weren't for some of our dealers who are really...
So you've got a dealer list on your website.
Yeah, we do. Buy local tap.
Okay. All right. Sounds great.
All right.
Well, thanks a lot for your time.
Thank you.
Good unit. Okay, so we met last year at the same gathering here.
Yes.
Penn State. And I got the hog halves from you. And by the way, just really quickly, these are a really popular way to get comb honey. And you sell them in 8 and 10 frame versions. But this year, you have something new for backyarders. And just tell me a little bit about, first of all, who you are and what your company is.
My name's Herman Dannenhauer. And I sell the Hogg Halfcomb comb honey system because John Hogg passed away and I bought the mold. And we came up with an idea for the smaller beekeeper that might want to make just 8 honeycomb. And this would take the place of 2 frames in your super, and you put your extracting frames on either side, and you'll get some extracting honey and 8 comb for friend and family.
Okay.
And we have 2 sizes, the medium depth frame, and we also have a shallow frame. The 4 cassettes go in 1/2. The cassettes are all pre-waxed with beeswax on them. And there's 2 halves involved to keep everything together. And then when you get comb honey, you just have to split the frame. And the first cassette out can be a little problematic, so we get it out with a suction cup. And then after that, the comb honey comes out real easy.
Oh.
So it's a very unique comb honey in the fact that the bees built it right in a serving tray. That's the serving tray. This is the finished product. I never cut it. I never touched it. The bees built it in there, and you sell it just as is.
So what's the best time of year? We have some new beekeepers, let's say, that are watching. Best time of year to start off with comb honey. It's pretty demanding resource-wise on the hive.
For me, where I live, it's spring. Spring, early summer honey flows are the very best, mm-hmm. where I live.
Yeah.
Some people get later flows, but in southeast Pennsylvania, I got to do my honeycomb in spring.
So what kind of preparation, what colony would we select for this? In other words, we want a big, strong spring colony, right?
It's
got to
be a good colony, yes.
Okay.
Yes.
So now this pre-waxing... The cassette comes with this already in, and you provide this already. What's the process for getting your beeswax started in here?
The cassette is a food-grade plastic that gets injection molded.
Okay.
And John Hogg made a machine that sprays beeswax onto the cassette.
Beeswax spraying machine.
Yeah, it's made just to spray beeswax on a cassette.
Do you have any idea what the temperature is that you're spraying the beeswax out?
Beeswax melts at 140.
Okay.
But we heat this to about 160 to keep everything flowing.
Okay.
And he made a wonderful machine that sprays these cassettes real fast.
Okay, so now are these considered reusable? Once they get your bees to draw out the comb, fill this, cap it, and then we, of course, package it as comb honey, is there any part of this cassette now that's reusable?
If you're using this for family, absolutely. I don't want to use a cassette someone ate out of and resell it.
Okay.
But they're perfectly usable. The bees would accept it all over again after you ate it and rinsed it out. Okay. I would just do that for my family.
Okay. So you can like melt it out even, right, with the residue. So what are we talking about? It says here half comb frame is $39, half comb frame $35.
This was put here if... At this show, if you buy more than one, I reduce the price to $35 a unit.
Yeah.
That's all that's about.
Now, where would somebody that's watching this video right now, where would they buy one?
This is available through Betterbee. They're going to distribute my products. And, of course, myself, I don't have time to ship out a little here, a little there. But if you wanted a couple frames and would come to my house, I would be glad to help you out.
Okay, so direct sales, but Betterbee is handling your online market.
Yes. Better,
okay, Betterbee, so they would just call it... Half, are these called Hogg Halves, or is there another name for it?
Hogg Halfcomb.
Hogg Halfcomb.
His name was John Hogg, the inventor.
Yeah.
And it's called the Halfcomb because there's no foundation and or midsection.
Okay.
This is just a half of a comb, making it very delicate when you eat it and consume it.
Okay.
Without having to eat the midsection.
Okay.
That's why it's called the Halfcomb.
And how long have you personally been doing that?
I've been making his comb honey for about 30 years, but I bought the system 10 years into it when he passed away.
Okay. So how's the interest overall in Hogg Halfcomb honey? Is it who is your number one buyer for comb honey in this format?
Myself.
Yourself. Okay.
But we sell a lot of units to a lot of people, but not so many.
Okay. Do you think people are not aware of comb honey so much that they're just really after a jar of honey or a bottle of honey?
Comb honey is challenging. Without a few years beekeeping experience, your success rate isn't very good. It's challenging and rewarding when you get nice comb. Okay.
Now that's the other thing. Once that comb honey is drawn out and capped, you want to get that off your hive pretty quick so that it stays nice and clean?
Yeah, it'll get travel stained if it stays on too long.
Yeah, okay.
I really haven't noticed a lot of that. I get behind on my schedule and I harvest later than I wish I did.
Yeah.
The comb is still pretty nice.
Okay.
It's still pretty nice.
Great. Well, I want to thank you for taking time to talk to me today.
Thank you.
Appreciate it.
You're welcome.